I think playing music is better.
Welcome to our weekly Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition Online role-playing adventures. We record our sessions every Sunday evening and upload them on Mondays. You can keep up with our adventures on my YouTube channel, as well as weekly session write-ups on my blog at roguewatson.com. I am Eric Watson, your Dungeon Master, and you can follow me on Twitter at roguewatson. I'm joined, as always, by my amazing players, Chris, playing Kalinar, Gold Dragonborn Paladin of Vengeance. Hello, Chris.
Hello, Eric.
Heather, playing Miri, the human monk of the elements. Hail, Heather. I don't think your mic's on.
Nothing.
I didn't hear you. I heard you, but I don't know if they can hear you. Didn't sound like it was coming through the headphones. Raymond, playing Kethra, the half-elf rogue arcane trickster. Hello, Raymond.
Hi.
And Reese playing Talus, the human wizard of divination. Did you know I was going to say that, diviner?
Reese. Roar!
For our campaign, we use roll20.net for video sharing. We use Google Hangouts for broadcasting and streaming. I use Open Broadcaster Software. At this point, recap last week's session. It's nobody will do the recaps but me. Previously on
When They Will Think About It.
Princes of the Apocalypse. Let's go to the Deseran Valley briefly. Well, you guys actually haven't been on the Deseran Valley in quite a while. And I meant to put Riverguard Keep on your map since you actually learned that location. Our heroes prepared for the worst as they went through the magically guarded door in the crypt of the Sacred Stone Monastery. They ascended the stairs and came face to face with a lich, one of the most powerful creatures on Faerun. Where's my handout? I like my picture of a lich. In the Eye of the Beholder series, which I totally stole that from. This was not your typical evil undead mastermind, however. Renwick Caradun was a former paladin. Through his thirst for knowledge, led him to create a potion of lichdom. It was his brother's love that ultimately transformed him. Renwick sought to create a holy shrine for his brother Samalar here in the monastery, but the Earth Cult moved in, and his brother's body remained squandered at Summit Hall. Renwick appealed to our interested heroes, and Kalinar looked past his hatred of undead to see Renwick's point of view on justice and Tyr. They agreed to help, and Renwick offered them numerous trinkets and rewards, as well as a safe place to rest. Renwick's lair was on the east side, so the party headed west, cleaning out the hallways and rooms of monks using ambush and stealth tactics. A boss fight with an extremely powerful and blind monk, the Abbess of Stone, nearly downed Kalinar. The party persevered thanks to a charm person spell from Talus that helped turn the tide, introduce them to a monk. Larry from State Farm. They continue methodically clearing out rooms and learning intel from their new ally, making it all the way back to the original entrance that they had been escorted through the day before. Now they have retreated to retreat to lick their wounds with about half the monastery remaining. Not my most eloquent job of a recap.
I'll take it.
You didn't stick the landing, but it was fine.
I did not, no. I apparently got bored with it at some point. All right, so you guys have just finished a short rest inside the library-type area?
Yes. The writing room?
Yeah, and then the guy you charmed is currently... tied up and ball gagged, I believe, in the corner, and is kind of fuming.
Yep. Does he still look friendly? Probably not.
He does not look terribly amused, no. And you guys would know that the way the magic works They remember everything that they were forced to do while they were magically induced.
Well, then he knows what's happening.
Most people probably don't like being dominated against their will.
How weird.
I know, right?
All right. Larry is tied up and gagged. I think there was a room to the west of the front door that had a bunch of guys in it.
Mm-hmm.
We should go kill him!
Kill those guys.
Post-haste.
I am as charged up as I'm going to get. I don't have any lay on hands points. But my health's almost full, so I'm ready to go!
Go for it. I won't stop you.
Open this door. Go open this door.
I'll hang back, though.
Yeah, there's bodies everywhere.
Yep. No. Although I could hear you in the background, Merrick.
What?
I was trying to talk.
Oh.
We never went in this room. Oh no, we can just see in here.
So that's the hallway.
We're back at the front entrance.
Yeah, you guys were led in there. It has a bunch of really imposing gargoyle statues outside and leading to the big double doors with the earth symbol carved into them, and that leads to the shrine.
Okay, right.
Which where you guys had the audience with the priest.
Okay. Let's open this door.
Stepping through that door, you notice somebody coming to the south. If you would like to react to that in some fashion.
I would like to charge at them. Sword drawn.
Charge at
from the north?
Yes.
I see him coming around the corner. Charge. How far do I get before...
Oh yeah, we did a bunch of sneaking stuff last time. Should have
we did.
Kept on doing that.
Probably. it did work last time.
So you can get to about here before I will roll for initiative.
Okay. Not the worst I've ever rolled.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
I have too many things. God, some of these late campaign combats are going to be insane for me.
All sorts of stuff.
Wow, you got a pretty good jump. But you guys did well. Also, even weller, in fact.
Mine was so bad, I took it for the team. All
that's better. Right.
Yeah,
yes.
you're still like checking out the windows and shit in there.
Gargoyle,
like,
too.
Musing about Larry in my head.
I wonder what Larry's thinking about right now. Probably murdering me.
Yeah.
Mary, you got the jump. You could type or lean over in my mic.
What happened to your... The mic she usually uses not work? Or I can talk to you and you can hear.
We're not sure, yeah.
Okay.
It does this from time to time.
There you go. Whatever you just did.
I didn't do anything. I opened up a Google window. That's all I did.
Wow.
Okay. Now I want to know if these other ones will work, because I like them a lot better. But we're not going to chance fate right now. All right. Go Google. You fix all the problems.
That's right. Just open Google. It solves everything.
This game brought to you by Google. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. Hello, Mr. Man.
Mr. Man must die.
Appears to be another monk with robes and a gargoyle mask. There are a lot of them in here.
Great.
I just meant the monastery in general.
Oh, right. Okay.
Hey.
That's, wow.
Mercy.
That's actually not that good.
No.
it looks impressive, but...
It looks a lot more impressive than what it actually was.
Exactly.
Both of those are going to hit for 13 damage as you crunch several important parts of his body. 14, he is going to use a parry as his reaction to add 2 to his AC, which will make that arm strike miss. So you come in with a punch and he deflects it.
He deflects the punch, but he takes the sword to the face.
Unfortunately, your attacks were too high for him to be able to parry the mace face attacks.
At least I parried that fist, guys.
Yeah. That fist attack would have been stronger than her first mace attack. Gethra.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Can't quite make it.
No.
I want to get close. Why not? Dashing. 35, 40, 45, 50. And then a rapier into him.
Into his body. Oh boy, that's solid.
20.
Jeez.
20.
That's gonna hurt.
You know, murder that guy.
It's gotta be massive damage at least, right?
Yeah.
I can't remember how strong these monks are.
Kill that guy.
But only just barely. What on earth are you doing over there?
I was trying to do some clever, but we'll just do this afterwards.
Stop being clever.
So, right. Why am I... Raymond, do I blame you for my echoing?
No, I think it's Heather's mic.
Oh.
I think it's picking you up, too.
Your mic's too sensitive. You wish to talk to him?
Hang on, let me switch to the other one, since we're done fighting.
Maybe, except this door is about to swing.
Ah, shit.
It's not worse. Wait, it's not so much worse.
Hang on a second. Stop.
I'm not sure for now. Alright.
Hey. She didn't agree to that.
While you're switching. No.
Damn it!
Open up a Google window.
Yeah. Wait, you're not supposed to be able to hear you. As you guys are fighting, this door is going to swing open. And what looks like a gray-skinned dwarf looks out with a very concerned expression on his face, sees all of you, sees the monk on the ground, and raises a like a weaponized war pick and shouts in dwarvish and appears to charge at you.
I speak Dwarvish. Do I, can I know what he says?
Sure.
I think he says
yeah. Yeah, Tal says too, so.
That was worse than the 5.
Yes, it was.
What's your microphone booth supposed to be at?
Well, where you're at now is pretty good.
Well, I'm worried about the echo from him.
Testing.
Yeah.
That sounds good.
Yeah.
All right, I'm not touching anything.
Let it settle. Duergars, evil minor dwarves.
So flustered, I screwed up the initiative roll.
Oh, no.
That's what I get for not eating dinner.
Alright. However, they actually rolled shit for initiative, so... Galanar.
Alright.
So, what did the dwarf say?
He said, "Brothers, we finally got some action. Intruders in the monastery. To arms!"
Okay.
There's a troop of evil dwarves, evil minor dwarves, that live in this monastery.
Electric pickaxes.
That's right.
Hey, I speak Dwarvish.
Yeah, you probably should have told us all what he said.
Yeah.
I don't know if all of us speak Dwarvish, but most of us.
Everybody speaks Dwarvish now. Jeez.
I don't.
10, 15, 20, 25. Ah, there's a shit ton of dwarves in here, guys.
All with mechanized axes.
Yep.
Weaponized, not mechanized.
Weaponized. So... Mechanized. Just spinning axe blades. I am going to, as a bonus action...
Oh my.
Do Shield of Faith. Get myself some AC. Then I'm going to look into this room, see all these dwarves.
How many are there?
5 that I can see. Might be some more. I'm just going to breathe fire into this room so hard. They're sleeping too, by the way. Like, a good number of them are asleep.
That's going to be a rude awakening.
Yes, it is. For shit damage, but... Well, any damage to everybody maybe won't be that bad.
It's our calendar.
Oh, no, you woke everybody up.
Hey, you only do 2d6, so that's pretty good damage.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Yeah, for that roll.
All right,
I thought you did more now.
At 6, I do more.
Try to help you out the best I can.
I probably just hit the...
It looks like I can get you to hit. I'll give you the sleeping guy.
Yeah.
Man, thinks he's asleep. I think means he just fails that dex.
That would make sense.
I mean, sleeping technically means unconscious, right?
Right.
Automatically fails dex saving throws, yes.
Oh, he is, you are echoing again, by the way.
Fire. Damn it. That's it.
Is he?
I didn't do nothing!
Yeah, I think when you were doing your test, you were just talking a lot quieter than you normally talk.
Yeah.
Then talk quieter.
You put you on push to talk.
She's got you there.
All right, so deck saves. I'll do bottom to top, so the top guy fails his automatically. So the guy closest to you...
Wow.
Makes the save and takes 4 damage. Next guy fails, takes 8 damage, and this guy's going to take 8 damage.
Yep.
Okay, Kethra, you hear some movement coming from this room. But for now it is your turn.
It is my turn?
Yes.
But what about the monks?
That was the sound you were hearing coming from the other
room.
That
was the sound you were hearing.
Oh, okay. There's monks and dwarves.
Yeah.
Got it.
Living side roll 20 by makes side it hard.
Some sort of I get it.
Roll 20 makes it hard to hide initiatives, but I'm still learning.
Yeah.
Kether says, did y'all hear that? I hear footsteps coming from the southeast. Five.
We're about to be flanked!
And
leap forth, brother protector, and save me!
15.
20.
Can't quite reach that guy, so I'll just shoot a... No. You guys got this.
That would be too easy.
Where was I? 5, 10, 15. I was up here? Yeah. 5, 10, 15, and I'm going to ready my rapier so that anyone who comes through gets... I attack them.
Through this door?
You could just say anyone who comes
within
melee range.
Anybody
yeah.
within melee range.
Within melee range? Okay. Miri?
Hey. Can you hear me? Yeah, you're a little quiet, but I can tell it's working. Keep talking.
I don't want to keep talking. So you don't want to tell me that you can hear him repeating himself.
I think you're...
Screw it. All right.
There you go. Yeah, you sound fine.
Try to find the best compromise.
Yeah. All
right. Mr. Dwarf Man here. Damn it.
Well, 17's not a bad hit. Just not rolling great for damage.
17 will hit, yeah. Bring your mace around and crack him with his dwarven beard. Dang. 2 also hit for 8 damage. 14 will not. Not quite. Alright, the duergar. You guys have created quite the choke point here.
Indeed.
He will clap his hands together, mutter some kind of arcane phrase, and grow in size.
Oh, what the shit? Miners don't get magic! What kind of bullshit is this? Double damage dice. Wow. Damage on straight chest. Wow. There was a mushroom in that room.
And he will swing his enlarged pickaxe.
One second.
Magic things are going to happen?
Are you going to shrink him?
In a way.
Sure, great. I should note this is not, I don't think, a spell. It is an innate trait that he has.
Oh, okay. Well, never mind then.
Never mind.
If I think you're doing what I think you're doing, which is counterspelling it.
I do like to counter things.
Yeah.
With spells.
Yeah. They are not spellcasters. They just, it's apparently a thing Duergar can do.
Of course. With their mechanized pickaxes.
That's right. However, he can only attack once, so he will swing his war pick at Kalinar. With its enlarged stats.
And doesn't do anything. Terribly. Yep.
Anticlimactic.
Back one will also grow in size.
For what purpose?
And that one will throw an enlarged javelin at you.
Oh, okay. No, it ties. Hit? Ties.
Tie hits, yeah.
Gosh. Okay. Well, I take that.
Giant spear.
Giant spear.
Unfortunately, the others are just going to have to wake each other up. You guys created quite the bottleneck in here. Let's see, what can you see? Alright, we'll have one more throw a regular size spear at Kalinar.
Nope.
Okay. Talus.
Put a fireball in that room.
I think it will engulf all you guys too.
Oh, okay. I don't know what the range of a fireball is.
Fireball's, I was looking up fog cloud and fireball, and both of those have really huge radiuses. Yeah.
Open this door and throw a fireball in there.
Hey, boys. Again.
I don't know if I can do that on one turn.
Yeah.
Speaking of chokeholds, I will step back.
And read a book.
Yep. I'll cast my favorite spell, Magic Missile, at the closest Durgar.
Huzzah!
The missiles slam into the dwarf, and his large size suddenly shrinks down as he collapses in a dead dwarven heap.
Oh, wow.
Huzzah!
You guys did a bunch of damage to him before.
Oh.
I don't know.
Mary did a bunch. I don't remember if Kalinar.
Yeah. Yeah, I hit
That's right. You did the fire. Yeah, you breathed fire, and then Mary struck him a bunch of times, so he was pretty damaged.
Oh, right. Forgot about that. I forgot about all of that. I'm back.
Round two, Kalinar.
I don't really want to actually go in here.
This room reeks of warrior.
Yeah. I'm going to step back, actually. Or you got reading description. While
a heavy wooden shutter covers the window of this room, making it quite dark inside. It is also very warm due to a large iron stove with a well-stoked fire. 10 uncomfortable-looking pallets lie on the floor amid tidy piles of iron arms and armor. Appears to be the Dwerger's sleeping quarters slash room. And you do notice that this window, I don't know if you can see that there's a window over there, is completely boarded up. No sunlight in this room. It is dark. But for the purposes of this adventure, I lit it like normal.
Should destroy the window.
Yeah. Put some light in here. Blind these suckers.
Roll a... I don't know. Insight, history, something if you want to know more about Dwerger.
All right.
Let's go with insight. I'm much better at insight than I am at history.
You would feel there's definitely a reason that they boarded up the window. You're pretty certain Dwerger are underdark dwelling creatures that are actually rarely seen on the surface.
Okay.
Guys, I got this.
All right.
Kalinar. Same information. You guys are all about at the same level of discourse for the Dwerger.
I'm going to... I don't know if readying actions can be a good idea. I'm going to stand right here and cast Bane on the big one, this one, and this one. They all have to make charisma saving throws. If they don't, they have to make a -4 attack roll. or a D4 minus. And the save is 13.
You know what, Chris, go ahead and add the hit points back to counter, because I think enlarge takes up their action, and I think I wasn't supposed to...
attack?
Be able to attack the same turn I enlarge. Oh. Yeah. As I'm reading over their abilities again.
I'll take it.
Yeah. I will always cut to my mistakes if I figure them out. Constantly having to deal with new things is a trial sometimes. Okay, so Baning, which one? Sorry, let me mark them.
The big one and the two closest to me, right up to the north.
We'll use this heart icon.
Well, they have to roll a charisma saving throw.
Oh, to resist it?
Yeah.
Gotcha. They don't have very good charisma.
I assume not.
11. What's the DC? All right.
13.
And then the one closest to you on the north side. All fail.
That's a bunch of miserable rolls.
They are pretty bad at charisma. They're not very likable.
Alright.
So whenever they make an attack roll or saving throw, they must roll a d4 and subtract it. This is the opposite of bless.
That is the opposite of bless. Yep.
Excellent. Okay, that's an action.
That is an action. I will just stand here.
It's in this door... going to open. This guy's going to come out and probably get eviscerated by Kethra's ready action, I assume.
Get stabified.
Do I have advantage or anything?
No, it's just a regular attack.
Okay.
You essentially like clicked wait on your turn or overwatch or whatever.
Okay.
Means he will use his parry. As he comes out, you stab at him, and he catches the blade with his hands.
Oh no.
However, that was his action going through the door. And then you see more approaching. But now it is Kethra's turn.
I see four monks, guys.
Oh dear, this is getting complicated real fast.
You woke up the barracks with your charge. Yeah.
He didn't even get a chance to charge.
Yeah, it's turned to charge.
That's true, everybody else killed him.
I can't remember if monks are strong or not, or have a lot of HP or not.
You fought a shit ton of monks by now, you should know the monks.
Yeah, they're not.
You literally killed a dozen of them in the last session.
Yeah, if that gives you any indication, we've killed a dozen of them. In one evening.
Let's try this. I'm going to cast sleep in the middle of them. Oh, nice.
Okay. I actually need to...
You know, this skill isn't useful anymore now that we're high level.
Yeah,
it's becoming less useful. Yeah.
Yeah, you're supposed to like put it at higher spell slots, I think.
I can't do that though. Mm. Time to find a new spell.
He's just a trickster. He's not a wizard.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Yeah, 1 second.
Sacred Stone Monk is typing.
I mean, that's a pretty good roll for a 5d8, but.
Yeah. I actually copy and paste these guys, so they all have the same hit points. I'm like, that's not fair.
Yes, it is.
Sure it is.
Well,
this is going to work in your benefit, though, because that's wouldn't have done shit.
Or you actually roll for the HP.
Yeah. I was like, wait, why are these guys all the same? That's not right. Alright, one of them will pass out.
Damn it.
Is it the one that was injured?
It's... none of these guys have been injured.
Uh-huh. Oh, no, that's right.
You killed that one.
The one right behind the door frame just slumps over.
And then I'm going to use my bonus action to disengage. And I'm going to run this way. 5, 10.
You're on your own.
We're safe. Yeah. From behind Talus, another door opens.
Guys.
Guys. And.
Wizard needs food badly.
That's the end of my action.
Okay, Mary.
Alright, so I guess I'll go up and fight the monks.
Yep.
You take a door, and you take a door.
Funny.
That guy has already used his reaction, so he can't parry.
Oh, I didn't use my...
Man, you rolled great for damage in the deck then. There you go.
That's good.
Smash his face up. 17 will hit. For he looks fairly wounded. Crush him around a bit.
That is a really big dwarfy thing.
Yep.
The duergar next. So now the big one will. Actually, you know what he's gonna do?
Sit there and cry.
No, here's what I'm gonna do. 5, 10.
The dwarves are discussing optimal positioning for themselves.
Yeah, he's going to try to bum rush past you.
Oh.
Which is going to invoke an attack of opportunity from you if you want to use your reaction.
Okay, sure. Yeah. Doesn't he have to roll something to even do it, or is it just an attack of opportunity?
I say you can just do it if you have your movement. It just takes double movement, but it does let you use your attack of opportunity.
Alright.
Well, I'll tell you what, we'll do a strength check since you probably are trying to bar this door.
Okay, well, yeah. Well,
let me think. Alright, would you rather have him come through and do the attack of opportunity, like kind of try to attack him as he comes through, or physically try to like get in a strength struggle with actually blocking his path?
I think I'd rather block his path.
Okay.
Even
let's
though
do a straight up, just straight up strength check, both of them.
Okay, strength check.
It's a check mark. Oops, that's
oh,
that
wow.
was the dwarger, not the monk. All right,
okay.
So he does.
Well, he comes through. Damn it, I chose poorly.
Yeah. that was his action, though. As he comes through, and then the...
well, hold on. Well, it doesn't matter. I was going to say, he has a roll of minus d4.
Oh, you're right, he does.
But it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter, yeah.
Over 13 anyway.
The big one will attack, and he will have to use his minus d4 for sure. With his enlarged war pick. Oh, damn. Make that a 22.
Fuck. Alright, well, 16 damage.
You are, thank goodness he did not have advantage on that roll, and flanking does not work for them. That would have been incredibly painful.
That would have been awful. Yeah.
Hold almost max damage on both numbers. Good job, giant dwarf. This one will use his action to enlarge.
Was that heartbeat again?
They're baned. They have to take a minus d4 to two rolls.
These two are just going to stay small and just kind of hang back there because they can't really get to you now. All right, Talus. Man, you guys did create a pretty good choke point, though. Just standing there.
So what does the heart mean?
They have to take a minus d4 to attack rolls or saving throws.
Yeah. And is there someone asleep?
Yeah.
There is a man asleep inside the door, I think.
Man. Okay. Not this guy.
A monk, yeah. All sorts of status effects are in play right now.
Alright.
How wide is that room? Is that 5 tiles or 4 tiles?
4. Okay. The duergar room, I assume?
Yeah.
Yeah. 20 feet wide. 4 tiles.
Okay, and where's Kethra? Or
back yeah. over here.
I imagine he's got like a sextant out, like in the couple seconds of his turn, just like trying to do calculations.
Each time, like I have an idea, but then it just changes so much and.
Yep. If situation it helps, I made tokens for all the area effect spells, so you should be able to see them easy. If you just tell me which one you're thinking about.
Hypnotic pattern.
Oh, shit. How big is that one?
It's a 30-foot cube.
30-foot cube. I might have a 30-foot cube. I do. I use it for Thunder Wave. It's also a 30-foot cube. Or no, that's a 15-foot cube, my bad. Well, we can just double it.
Enlarge.
Oops, that's the basement. Monastery. All right, so this is 15. So 20,
25, 30. Holy crap! Yeah.
It's a 30-foot cube.
Now you can center it like on the edge of the room, right? Does it have to all be inside the doors?
Is it just the center has to be a point you can see? Is that the rule?
I think so.
So if you were to put the center, yeah, right, like right there, in the corner.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll do that.
Okay. Move that to the back so I can see. That's gonna hit all four of those guys. Not a pattern. Yeah, I made a bunch of tokens. I forgot about that one, but Thunderwave kind of looks like it could be a similar effect.
Close enough.
Yeah, the colors and patterns seem really similar to what hypnotic pattern should be.
Yeah, because I know we had a lot of problems with that, especially with Fog Cloud. Like, my Fog Cloud didn't look really well, so I just went ahead and used the same program I used to make all your tokens, and I made a bunch of AoE spells.
Nice.
Okay. Do you have a 20-foot radius circle?
You want to see it?
I would like to see it. Curious.
I'll show you. I have one for Fog Cloud and Fireball. Which one would you like to see?
Fireball.
See all your new toys, Wizard.
A graphical update.
Boy.
Ooh.
How's that for a Fireball?
That looks pretty cool. Like a sun.
Yeah. That's right. Power of Flaming Sun. Alright, so Nautic Pattern, they have to roll 15. They will affect their Duergar resilience, so they advantage on spells.
Uh-oh.
On their saving throws.
Unless they have the -4.
Well, they'd have advantage, but they'd still do the -4.
Two of them have the -4.
Yeah.
Two of them have been baned, so I will
do the calculations, DM.
Yeah. I'll do the non-bane ones first. Top to bottom. So they do have advantage. So 19, he resists, and then the big guy in the lower left, 18,
damn.
He resists. Now the guys that are bane, top guy is going to fail no matter what.
Didn't hit.
And what does that do? Does that get sleep spell?
Yeah.
Or no, they're charmed. Wait.
No.
So we can assume they're orby charmed.
They're incapacitated.
Incapacitated,
yeah.
Gotcha.
So it's like that's like a stun, like the snake from Jungle Book, just sort of go into a trance.
Take actions or reactions, yeah.
Did you watch the Jungle Book?
I haven't seen it yet, no. Oh. But in the cartoon, that's what the snake did.
Oh.
Gotcha. So technically not sleeping, but they're.
Yeah, they can still get woken up.
Okay, and then the lower right guy. Now this could matter. 17.
Yes.
Rolls a 17.
So do the D4.
So
if it's a 3 or 4, then it's fine. Hey, look at that!
Hey! Because nice. Of his bane, he fails. He also goes in a slumber. So you knocked out half of him.
Hooray! That was worth my level 3 spell. Should have
Okay, round 3, Kalinar.
Good to know that they're resistance again.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah. Learn something about Duergar now.
Yep.
So the one in front of me is asleep, right?
Yes, the big guy. Which I don't know if they didn't say they revert, but.
Okay. Don't really want to wake him up. Well, if they say if they take damage, takes damage.
If they take damage or someone else uses an action to wake them up.
Yeah. Well, in that case, okay, I'm going to... Seeing that the one in front of him is... Yeah, the, but yeah, yeah, I suppose. But both Kether and Miri are over there. They can handle that one.
I've only got four monks in front of
me. Monks are nothing.
You got that right.
See, the one in front of him is asleep. He's going to take a step into the room and turn into a golden, shimmering image.
Oh, boy.
And reappear right here.
Oh, boy. Kalanar just disappears from the rest of you guys.
He's just charged into the room.
Yep.
And I'm going to take a swing at the large one.
The large one.
A 10 won't hit.
That was a terrible, terrible swing.
Yep. Another swing. A 26.
26 will hit. 14. That is pretty good. Not quite massive. You take a good blow out of his enlarged form, and he appears to reel and growl at you. Say something about your mother in Dwarvish. Alright. Was that it for you?
Yeah, that's it.
Go. The monks. This one will step up. This one is going to use an action to wake up his buddy that fell asleep in front of him. And then the other one will go 5, 10, 15. And both of those guys will attack Mary.
Of course they will.
Holding off the back end. These guys do multi-attack, though.
Of course they do.
First guy, 12 and 20.
20 will hit.
Punchy, punchy.
Pouchy, sleepy.
Oh, dear.
Wow. Everyone just whips it.
Embarrasses himself.
Yeah.
Alright, Kethra.
Kethra's not sure why Kalanar just disappeared.
What happened? He was right there.
Now, if I use my reaction, if I use my bonus action to disengage, is that the whole, during the whole turn? Or is it just once?
It operates for the whole round.
Okay.
I think.
If I try to pass through two people...
You can use one reaction to disengage. I think that works for all those people. I don't know the exact rule, but I'm going to roll that yes for now.
Okay, so I can only do it once then.
I mean, if you want to use a bonus action to disengage, then I'm saying you could run through a bunch of people because you used your...
Oh, okay. I will do that then. I'm going to use my bonus action to disengage. So 5. 10. And then can I jump over this guy? 15, 20. 25. 30?
Yes, since you used disengage, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it just says... Your movement doesn't provoke opportunity attacks for the rest of the turn, so that absolutely... Oh, okay. You can use one disengage and move through a billion guys, doesn't matter.
Awesome. And then I'm going to hit this guy with my rapier.
Yes, you are, and you're going to murder that guy. Holy crap.
Huzzah.
Just stab him from behind. Crush.
Man, can't do much more than that damage.
No, that was insane. 27.
And that is the end of my turn.
Okay, Mary.
Alright. I guess I'll attack this guy. I'll move here first. No, I'll stay right there. So.
Ooh, crit.
Wow. Crit damage is shit, but yep. Good job still.
It's more damage. 12.
Not massive damage?
Not quite, but pretty damn. He looks pretty fucking wounded from that.
Just a How about now? Crunch.
Yeah, that's a pretty good crunch.
Good Damn! Lord.
He is reeling from the blows.
Getting those headshots in.
Yeah. Not quite. 2 out of 3 is pretty fucking good, though. Duergar, this guy's gonna grow big. Burp, 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 burp.
So are you saying in this universe that is the sound it makes? Are you making that up?
I am the god of this universe, so yes, yes it is. E-new-chuck. that is his action, but he will go ahead and step up here. Large dwarf frame. And then Kalinar is going to get attacked by the other two in the room.
Sure he is.
So yeah, really like that business. We'll do the small guy first. So he does not have... Big pick.
Damn, okay. 3? That was thankfully shit damage.
Absolute awful for damage.
Little pick.
And then the enlarged war pick.
No! Oh. Thank God!
The little one hit and the big one missed. No!
I imagine the big one just came down with that pickaxe like right beside me and took a chunk out of the floor.
When they grow big, they lose their brains.
Dallas. Dallas has options.
Yes. Alright, I'll cast Firebolt at this guy right here.
Yep.
Nice.
20.
Firebolt the connects.
Yeah, guys, engulfed in flames.
Nice.
Crumples to the ground, screaming as smoke pours out of his gargoyle mask, and it like melts to his face like Game of Thrones gold style.
Tal says, "Interesting."
So
opens his notebook and makes a note.
Yeah, he makes a note.
Fire causes him to die screaming. Kalinar.
Kalinar, once again, take some swings at the big one. 24, I assume, will hit.
That is gonna hit. 14 damage. This one, you take a good, like, chunk out of his leg, and he kind of stumbles into the wall and takes a chunk out of the wall. He's spitting blood and kind of wipes, like, flecks of blood out of his mouth, but appears to still be... on his giant feet.
Alright, he will swing again. Fourteen's not gonna do it.
No. Not quite. He laughs at you.
That's it.
Alright. Monks have gotten hurt quite a bit. 5, 10, 10. We'll split it up. 1 to Miri, 1 to Kethra. As they come out, don't say a word, and just pummel.
Which one you do first?
Which one's first?
Huh?
Which one's first?
We'll do Miri first. Go left to right. They appear to have just woken up. They're a little groggy.
Have they put their armor on?
Yeah.
That
they
takes some time.
They do not wear armor.
Oh, shit, that's right. We don't wear armor.
Whoa, okay. Weapons. Oh. Ow, those are some good hits.
That hurt.
Some good hits.
Yeah.
Would you like to use dodge?
I can't go anywhere. And I use my bonus action.
Yeah.
I'd like to use dodge, but I can't. Again, after they're done.
Kethra's.
One of them.
17.
It's not worth a spell. I'm gonna use Uncanny Dodge as a reaction. And
You used your reaction to disengage from everybody.
Oh, no, that was a bonus action.
Oh, yeah, it was.
Damn.
You win this time. You and all your fucking actions, I swear. Technicality. Alright, have the damage. So you take 3 damage. And that's it for the monks. Kethra.
Oh. Is that door still open?
The door behind them?
Uh-huh.
Yes.
I'm going to do the same thing I did. I'm going to use my bonus action to disengage. And I will jump over this guy. 5, 10, 15. And hit the guy straight in between Lyra and I.
Teen will hit for 22 damage.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, sorry, 22.
That is going to be massive damage for that monk. She will suffer from.
Can't take reactions.
Can't take reactions, yep.
That what 10 is? I thought that was like 6 and 7. Okay.
It's pretty much anything above 5.
You guys want a lower number on that roll. The lower number means he's like outright dies. The higher number means mild inconvenience. He's slightly shaken from the blow. However, he looks pretty near death. Like that was a pretty deep strike.
It's the end of my turn.
Mary.
Alright, so I'll attack the same guy.
You do have advantage, so the 27 will absolutely destroy his face. You just crush it inward with your mace. Not even his own mother could recognize him. Smash the gargoyle mask, just gets embedded in his flesh.
One gets burned on, one gets embedded.
Yeah. Just awful.
And then I will turn and attack the big guy. Not so much.
13 is not going to hit.
And then, as my bonus action, because I'm getting a lot lower on health points, I will take patient defense and take the dodge action as my bonus action.
Turn the attack only against you with disadvantage. Okay. And it is the duergar next, so. That one will attack you, and he already also has to minus d4.
Mm-hmm.
So he has a disadvantage and has to roll a d4 to try and hit you. With his enlarged war pick.
This is gonna matter!
So
16 minus a d4. Yeah.
16 minus a d4.
And he swings and misses.
12. Nice. That was a good combination of things. Swing and a miss. The other guys are knocked out, so the other two will attack Kalinar.
One's at Come at me!
Alright, small guy first swings his war pick.
Fuck! what are their bonuses? Just 4, so they're just rolling well. Okay.
Yeah. That's an 18 I rolled. Big guy says, I will finish this. Oops, my bad. Wrong button. He's already enlarged.
He gets even bigger.
He was so befuddled. I try to enlarge, and his body goes, It's like, what am I doing? That big guy can't hurt shit. Dallas.
How injured does this monk look?
He's not at all.
He's not been attacked, yeah. I believe he's the only living monk left.
Let's change that. Can't really do much, but I'll firebolt that guy, the monk. There you go.
Mine's not gonna do it.
No. And I'll move up.
Nice.
You should have moved here first. Before you did it.
Up there?
Yeah. Right.
Now you're thinking like a Kethra.
Oh, I didn't know Kethra was right there.
Talos doesn't know where half the people are, because you guys all ran into rooms.
All these shadows.
Kethra. No, Monk. No. Kalinar. Oh.
Me, yes.
Where are we?
There's
two fights. I know, I'm so screwed when these more complicated fights happen.
I want to continue to hack away at the big dwarf.
You guys just having your own separate battle over there.
Oh yeah, absolutely. 16?
16 will just hit.
I get to reroll that damage.
You don't need to.
That was a question. That's why I didn't see this as a statement.
You take your sword and shove it up into his, like, joints between his armor, up into his gut. Just explodes in blood.
Well, then now I have two more attacks.
Say that when they die, they revert. Do.
All right. Little one for 13. And then the...
Yes, that will...
Yep.
Yeah, 13.
And the cleave attack.
That's actually massive damage.
Oh, okay. We'll do that first then. I'll hold on to this roll for a little while.
A 5, eh? I don't know what that means.
Yeah. Can't
take reactions.
They all mean can't take reactions.
Target is stunned and cannot take any actions or reactions at the end of his next turn.
Okay. Well, I also hit him again. But that 22 hit.
Yes.
And I do need to reroll that damage.
Okay.
1d10 plus 5. There's the real damage for 9.
9. Alright, you take a deep cut and appear to nearly decapitate him.
He's got sinew holding his head on?
He has sinew holding his head, it's pretty gross. He is stunned and looks like he is beyond knocking at death's door. He's already got, like, just passing through.
Okay.
The one living monk. Is undeterred. And, he is going to strike at... Let's see, who killed the last monk? Was that Talus or... Miri? You crunched a face in, didn't you, Miri?
Yeah.
Alright, he's gonna type Miri. For Jonathan, he screams.
Were they lovers?
Possibly.
No!
He was my world.
Oh, man. Ugh. Even with the dodge, that still hurt.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah, 16 is with disadvantage on both of them.
Yeah.
But he rolled shit for damage.
Shit, whatever, I'm still already almost dead.
Yeah, you've absorbed a lot of blows. Kethra.
Kethra is puzzled by his exclamation for Jonathan. But says, if you wish, I will send you alongside Jonathan. Oh, shit.
Grant you death's release. Oh, you were distracted by his outpouring of affection.
Yes,
you're befuddled.
I don't know how to take this.
I don't know if they could love to change this everything. They were all evil. Miri, assuming you're not moving, get through.
I guess 12 didn't hit.
12 does not hit.
Yeah. No, I'm not moving.
Semi-competent monks.
What about an 18?
Is this the duergar or the monk?
Let's do the duergar.
Okay. That is hitting. 8 damage. 16 will hit, as Kalinar has discovered, for 10 damage. He appears quite wounded.
How wounded?
Quite. Wounded.
Twice!
As you smashed his armor in quite a bit.
I can cast patient defense again.
Okay.
That's the only thing that saved my life last time.
Yeah, that works. The duergar are next, and literally everybody in Kalinar's room is incapacitated.
That's right!
Only duergar will attack Miri.
attack talus, but
with disadvantage and with a minus d4. You assholes and your debuffs, swear to goodness. So many debuffs. Alright, so enlarged war pick. 14.
Doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter. Alright. That base defense too. Has been really well for you.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, he swings it, but you're like centered in and you like dodge out of the way in a rapid motion. That is all I have for the duergar, Talus.
Which one looks almost dead?
Of the duergars?
Yeah.
There was one Kalinar was fighting that's nearly decapitated, and it's right next to him.
You can't see him. He's
the one, the big one in the doorway is wounded, and this one I described as being quite wounded.
Okay.
Many bloody wounds.
I will cast the sure bet at level
the sure
two.
Bet.
All of
safety
them.
Damage. Oh boy, that's solid.
All to the duergar.
The close one.
Yeah.
17 damage. Alright. All four of them slam into him. He reels backwards. Goes crashing down from the might of it.
He never wake up. He dies peacefully in his sleep.
Yeah. Like, has this brief second of extreme pain. And
that's right.
Alright. Back up to Kalinar.
Let's finish off this little sucker. That's not gonna do it.
No. No, it's
let's
not.
Let's try that again. That might do
that'll
it.
That'll do it. As you give him a little coup de grace angle, because if he's already stunned.
That's right. And is this one dead? I thought this one was dead. Or no, the one in the hallway.
The two that are left in. Yeah, there's one underneath. There's a body underneath him. These two were hypnotically gazed or whatever, so they are
right.
Incapacitated.
Okay, are either one of them wounded?
The big one in the hallway is wounded, yes. Was wounded right. Before he got incapacitated. He was the one you were actually fighting initially.
Right, okay.
I believe.
Well, then I'm going to attempt to coup de grace him right in the face with cleave attack.
He does count as being unconscious, right? Or is it just incapacitated? Because the weird thing is there's an incapacitated and then there's also an unconscious. So like two different states. That's what's confusing.
The rules are different for taking attacks?
Maybe if they're unconscious, they can't be shaken awake.
Well, it just says. Oh, maybe. That's true. That might be. Because it does say unconscious means they have the incapacitated condition as well as they dropped whatever they're holding, falls prone, and they have all those disadvantages and things. So that might be just when they hit zero.
Oh, right.
But so the only thing an incapacitate is they can't take actions or reactions. There's nothing about, like, giving you advantage or anything like that. Which seems weird, since they're incapacitated.
It does seem weird. He's just standing there.
Yeah.
He's not going to dodge.
I know.
What is his armor or
reading, so. And presumably he wakes up, obviously, if he's attacked.
If he takes damage, yeah.
If he takes damage, yeah. That's true. If you miss, it's nothing.
He doesn't know.
He doesn't know. None the wiser.
All right. Well, yeah, I'll go ahead and swing at him.
Yep.
19
will hit.
And as it hits, that familiar golden light's gonna come pouring out of it.
He doesn't like golden light, not one bit.
Probably not. For 7 more damage.
All right. He appears to just hang on to life. Being woken up by that, the sword sticking out of his, like, rib cage, and then the light pierces into his chest, and he opens his eyes and mouth, and just light comes streaming out of, like, every orifice. And he gives off a horrifying scream and falls dead. Oops. And you door.
And the door comes unhinged.
The door comes, oh, yeah. Good lord, you were just making a mess of things in there.
That's right.
Did you already get your cleave off?
That was my cleave.
That was a cleave. All right, that was a damn good turn. The monk! Can he finish off Miri? You still have patient defense on, I think, though. Mm. 21 should still hit, but 5 is not gonna hit. Mm. That's all my monk can do.
I have 4 hit points.
You were Kalinar in the big boss fight
last time.
Yeah.
I have no health potion. I don't think.
You're just getting you're the Daredevil hallway fight. You're just fighting like a dozen dudes at once.
Good lord.
Wow.
I'm not even gonna calculate that. That is a straight death. You just did some kind of cool ass combo move. Eviscerated him in the blink of an eye. Jesus.
It's that like video game rapier move where someone just goes like stabs a bunch of times.
Yeah. Just like a flurry of animation.
That's 37 damage.
With Jonathan.
That's insane.
For Jonathan.
Yeah, you can go meet Jonathan. Miri.
What? Who's left?
There is one incapacitated duergar in the barracks left.
Who's just sort of standing dazed right now?
Yes, essentially.
I'm just
open up the window.
Like, I should just see what happens.
And just like fall onto one of these beds.
Combat's not over, but she didn't care.
I'm so sleepy.
I'll ready my knife if I need it. My face. I can't stand anymore.
I can do nothing with the duergar, so it is Dallas.
Alright. Can I set the window panelings on fire? Burn them off?
Yes.
Alright. Go, firebolts.
Kalos really wants to know what happens if a duergar sees
him. Oh, the one time he doesn't see an actual person.
Yeah.
The appears to catch flame. Looks like they will burn. In probably a round, maybe? A couple seconds, you'll start seeing sunlight. Kalinar!
You should have just hit the window in the first place.
I will satiate Talos' curiosity, and I'll step over here and attack the window pane, try to hack it off.
The burning window pane?
The burning window pane.
It's boarded up with wood, essentially.
Yeah, let's try to just smash it.
Alright, between the fire and your smashing, you can smash a good chunk in, and the sunlight comes in. Lights the room up a bit. Nothing immediately happens to the dwarf, but he is, and he's still stunned also, but you notice his eyes start to like water a bit, and he tends to like kind of just shake around and looks weakened. And Kethra.
5, 10, 15, 20. And I will ready my crossbow for anything within range.
Alright. Miri?
Alright, now I'm curious.
we're all just conducting a medical experiment in this room.
30, 35. Okay, where is it? I gotta move over. Okay. Then 40. How close is this one to death?
I
don't think he's been touched.
He is wounded.
Okay. Oh, that's right. I probably breathed fire on him earlier on.
I think so.
Hmm.
10 is not going to hit.
Let me incapacitate him.
He is, but as I said, I don't think that. The only thing it says is that they just can't take reactions or reaction. It doesn't say it gives you guys any bonuses. 20 will hit for 6 damage. Crush is facing. 24 will hit for 8 damage. He appears extremely wounded. Badly wounded, one might say.
Now it's his turn.
Now it is his turn.
Now you'll get to see what happens to Ellis.
Yeah, he will, he blinks back the tear, like, his eyes are just, like, kind of fucked up, and he actually has to hold a hand in there, and he goes, "Argh!" And he, attempts to swing at Kalinar.
Good choice.
Oh,
Kalinar did, like, murder all his friends in this room.
That's right.
But he has disadvantage on this roll because of his sunlight sensitivity. Seven.
Okay. 16 wasn't going to hit either, but...
Well, Dallas. He had a roll minus d4 anyway, so...
Yeah.
Can we kill the weakened, baned, sunlight-sensitive dwarger?
Can we finish this? We're just watching this poor dwarf just flail wildly. We're burning an anthill or something.
Heroes! Our heroes, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, he appears extremely uncomfortable in sunlight.
Okay, I'm going to touch part of his armor and bathe it in light.
You know what, Talos? You can have inspiration for that.
You're a sadistic monster.
Because that is fucked up. He kind of howls in, like, anguish.
I can't escape the light! It's coming from everywhere!
Yeah. His eyes are, like, completely, like, dilated and just absolutely watering. He's practically crying. Kalinar.
Alright, Kalinar's gonna put this...
I'll give you advantage on this attack since he's so all fucked up from the light.
I'm just gonna just try and just behead the guy, put him out of his misery.
And you do.
Enough of this!
He goes down in a crying, miserable heap.
Here, he just collapses on one of the cots.
That was a hell of a fight.
Yeah, that was a big one. You alright, Mary? Oh, you don't seem so hot.
I'm gonna need a few minutes.
The monks have nothing on them, as the monks never do, but the duergar, there's nothing in this room specifically, but they do have some coinage on them, if you guys want to loot the bodies.
Sure.
Always. Loot them all.
My last three remaining hit dice and try to not be dead.
If you guys want a short rest, you can. You guys can roll 2d10 for every duergar, and that's how much gold they have on them, and there are 6 duergars.
So we just do that as one big heap.
12d10.
12d10. I'll roll it. 12d10.
We can rest for a few minutes, right?
Oh, sure. 46 gold.
46 gold.
That's terrible.
It is not a great roll. You're right.
11 apiece.
That's
with two
a lot of ones and no 9s or 10s.
Yep. Yeah, it's 11 apiece, 2 left over. Yeah.
Well, they were poor dwarves.
Poor dwarves, yep.
I'll take one of the extra.
Anything? For nearly dying.
anything of interest in this room? Besides just over...
Yeah, it looks like they kept a pretty meager existence.
Are we short resting? Since Mary's rolling hit dice? Okay.
This is your second short rest of the day. And a good time for a break?
Yeah.
Probably. Yay, I can get dinner.
Alright, take a break. Reconvene in a few minutes.
Executive decision, short rest.
I like how he gave a thumbs up before he told us what it was for.
I think we're ready to go. You guys might have to unmute. There you go. So yeah, you guys short rest in the room. You guys are used to, like, resting around dead bodies. I'm a little worried about your general hygiene.
You know, yeah, we used to move dead bodies out of the area. At some point, we just got lazy. Gave too much work.
I don't know, man.
Would anyone like any good berries? I have 10 HPs worth.
How you doing?
Yeah. Yeah. Work one of those over.
All right.
I keep forgetting you have those.
Yeah. How many?
Just one.
Okay.
Actually, that's just one. Two. That's just one HP.
Oh, it's just one HP?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. He's got 10 berries. They're one HP apiece.
Mm. Think of it like Eleanor's lay on hands. You've got up to 10 of them.
Let me do 5.
Okay.
I'll take the other 5.
All right.
Frontline fighters munch down on some nutritious healing berries.
So does each good berry, I mean, since each one counts as a ration, are they just extremely full now?
Yeah.
It doesn't, yeah, I mean, they count as a ration. It doesn't say how much it fills you. It just says that it can sustain you. So
yeah,
whatever magic you want to apply to that.
Or it's like they're at that stage where they're not hungry, but they're not full. They sort of feel gross.
I'm bloated.
Just super bloated, yeah.
Yeah.
Feeling comfortable. Disadvantage on charisma checks. Alright, nothing else seems to come down the hallway as you guys plop down for a quick rest after the fight.
Alright, let's go and check out this room.
Yeah, you've noticed no sound has come out of this one either.
Oh, I didn't notice that. Oh, I didn't even notice that door.
So many bodies.
Yep. Is there anything in this room? Or is it just bed of rolls?
What room are you in? 3. This room is arranged in a very uncomfortable-looking barracks. 10 thin pallets are rolled up along the walls. Bedside, nearly folded piles of clothing, plain, dun-colored robes and sandals. 2 of the clothing piles also include golden masks in the shape of the scowling gargoyle faces. So clearly this is a room for the monks. No other furnishings. A single window looks toward the canyon wall to the south. These guys lived in monkish poverty.
Can I take the robes and one of the masks and put them on so that way I can, like...
Yes, you can. Absolutely.
So that way I can walk in front of everybody and see what's going on before.
Yep. The especially since you're not wearing any armor, the robes easily fit over your whatever robes you're wearing. And, yeah, you can put the mask... It's a one-size-fits-all golden gargoyle mask.
Would you like to walk into this room with your golden gargoyle mask on?
Probably a good idea. Excuse me, Catherine.
Out the way.
Okay. I would like to open the door.
The door is locked.
Damn it, Catherine, lock the door.
Come back.
Come back here.
She just shakes her head.
Alright, you hear a successful click as you lockpick the door with your insanely good rogue skills.
She walks off again.
Alright, this appears empty. Let's see, 4. 8 simple bunks line the walls of this room, each with a small trunk at the foot of the bed. A small table and several wooden chairs stand in the middle of the room near an iron stove. 5 of the bunks are bare, but 3 are comfortably made up with sheets, pillows, and blankets. And yes, you notice, just a cursory sweep around the room, an iron coffer beneath one of the bunks, which looks very neatly done. I'd like to open it. It is locked.
Your mic's back off again, by the way.
I know. I'm trying to, like, turn it off when I eat chips, and then I forget to turn it back on.
Oh, okay, I gotcha.
Trying to be polite.
16. Yeah. You just managed to click that leg lock open. And, inside, I'll type this out.
Well, we're all standing around. If she's pulling stuff out of there, we're seeing it.
Well, I'm not whispering it. I'm typing it out just so you guys know it.
Oh, okay. I thought you were like...
No.
you secretly pull out a bag of coins.
I'm literally just typing it out so you guys... Because a lot of times I just have to repeat this stuff, so...
That's true, yeah.
It's easier, especially if it's a big loot pile.
That makes sense.
No, get those, like, counter. Look, over there. It's a monk. And then she pulls it out.
Draw my sword and charge. Away.
I have to... I'm going to assume these are wizard scrolls, but I actually don't know. I'm just going to go ahead and tell you what they are. And then I'll look up in a second if they're... So you find 120 gold, 90 electrum pieces, priestly vestments made out of spun gold worth 40 gold pieces, leather pouch containing 2 gold bracelets, 30 gold pieces each, and 3 spell scrolls, all earth-themed.
Are they all wizard-based?
I'm looking that up now. Earthbind, Maximilian. Okay, looks like Transmute Rock is actually a druid spell, but the other two are wizard spells. They're both level 2 wizard spells, so... ignore that Transmute Rock, just say it's a spell scroll you can't quite identify. You could say druid spell if you want. Or you can go ahead and say what it is on your inventory screen. They're all level 2 spells.
Okay. Are they from the...
Yes, and I'd link to that in the Facebook group. So
yeah,
a lot of the new spell, a lot of the spells you'll see are from this because they want to show off all their new spells. So a lot of the scrolls.
I would like one of the bracelets.
So the total gold is 220, so that's 55 a person. So one person gets a bracelet and up to 55. One person gets the gold up to 55. No person just gets 55. Does that make sense?
And then the electrum will just divide evenly?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Yeah, that makes sense.
So Kether will just take the gold, because you don't have to deal with selling stuff.
I will take the priestly vestments and 12 gold.
No, it goes up to 55.
55. 15 gold.
Oh, that Maximilian Earth and Grass sounds cool. Literally, you form like a stone hand out of the ground, and it grabs your enemy and crushes
it. Oh, that's neat. Nice. That sounds nice.
A 5-foot square unoccupied space on the ground you can see within range. A medium hand made from compacted soil rises there and reaches for one creature you can see within 5 feet of it. The target must make a strength saving throw on a failed save. The target takes 2d6 bludgeoning damage and is restrained. As an action, you can cause the hand to crush the restrained target, so you can actually use your turn to do the hand's attack.
Wow.
I'll have to find a cool graphic for that.
Pal, she wants the bracelet?
Yeah, so a bracelet and 25 gold.
Yes.
Okay. And how many electrum pieces?
22. Although 2 people get 23. And Kether already took the 1 extra.
The loot. I will say you guys also find 2 potions of greater healing.
I'll take one.
Oh, I'm still claiming the other one.
Alright.
I'll take the extra electrum piece.
I'm slowly realizing you guys have less healing capabilities than most adventuring parties, so I'm trying to supplement that.
We're shock and awe. Yeah.
And the shock is that you have to then rest after
it. Yeah.
And the greater healing is 44 plus 4.
Okie doke.
That appears all that's in that room.
Let's go north first. This hallway with dragon or gargoyle statues. Alright.
It's unlocked. Who's going through? What's going on?
Kether will go through.
Kether's going through.
Coast clear, guys.
Four old wooden tables with bench seats stand in the middle of this room, and shelves full of plain clay crockery and wooden platters line the walls. To the west, two windows look out into the canyon beyond the monastery walls. Two doors lead from this room to the north, and then obviously the room to the south you guys came in. So this appears to be a dining room, basically.
Are these plates worth anything?
You don't think so. They're very poorly constructed, simple clay bowls and plates.
I smash a couple clay cups just for fun.
Kether smashes two also.
This door opens in response to the noise.
Oh no!
Somebody pokes their head out and says, and the combat will begin.
There's just four assholes out.
Assholes can't just go and smash and plate.
Wow! I rolled a 5, then a 4, and now a 3.
Oh, okay. Well, you should eventually just reset back to the top, right?
What are the odds?
You roll a 20 next time. That'd be amazing.
Yeah.
Smashing. You're the hubris, I swear to goodness. This is an unexplored room. Time to make some noise.
Yeah.
Disgusting. God damn. Some really good initiatives and some really bad ones. What the hell? Thankfully, it's not Shadowrun, and the actual number doesn't matter, only in relation to each other. Miri, you were first.
And I'm still
incognitus. yeah, unfortunately, you were not the first one they saw. They saw a dragon man breaking plates.
Which actually works in my favor. So,
Heather's still muted.
I know.
15,
20,
25, 30. 35.
You're walking towards him?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Help me. They've taken me from the hallway.
Roll...
Hey, I'm incognito.
You are.
It looks like one of them.
Roll persuasion.
Oh.
I'll give you advantage.
It's probably not going to matter.
Help me! I have been taken hostage!
Help me get away from these people!
Kind sir or madam?
Alright, seeing that my ruse isn't gonna work.
Well, he appears confused more than anything. Like, he's not sure what's going on. He looks like his hostility is still trained on the dragon man.
I shall wait then.
Do you want to ready anything, or just...
I'm gonna ready my, already Lightbringer behind my back, so he can't see it.
Okay. You're getting ready in action, though, at all?
The
attack with it, right? That's...
Yeah, if he makes it this far into the room, second step.
Okay. Kether, you're next.
Kether leaps into action using her bonus action. 5, to dash. 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. Oh, shit. can I
so
go
this back room appears to be the kitchen area, and it is decently loud. Back here, there's some noises, like stoves going and stuff, but they could definitely hear the next room over.
40 steps. Rapier.
Now, you did not... Hang on.
Huh?
You used your bonus action to dash, but not disengage, right?
Oh, I went diagonally through the door. Can I do that?
But you still got past him, and he gets that attack of opportunity.
No, I'm going around him. Or is he blocking the door?
Yeah, he's in the doorway.
Oh.
I mean, you can get past him, but he gets that roll.
No, it's okay. I'll just stop there. And I will sneak attack him.
Ouch. you run up to, in one running motion, you, like, are running up on top of, like, dining room tables and do a flying leap forward with rapier pointed out and just stab him in the chest, and he falls to the ground. Deadsies.
How many steps did I take? Let's hear. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30.
It's like you never stopped moving when you, like, stabbed him.
Rolled over him.
And then, I will use my bonus action to dash and leap back and say there's two more guys in there.
Okay.
And here they come.
So the one you persuaded is dead now. The one you failed to persuade. The monks will see their fallen comrade and immediately charge out. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. So this one will make it out here.
Excellent.
He seems to kind of ignore you since you're in the garb, and instead go after Kalinar since he's that's who he saw murder his buddy.
Kethra?
Yes, no, so you Kalinar. Can attack.
Kalinar just smashing plates. He didn't murder
no,
anybody.
He means Kethra.
Okay.
But yeah, Miri gets that free attack. Which I will not let him parry since he was not aware of your attack. That just surprised him more than anything. 6 damage.
Just bonked him in the back of the head as he's walking.
Conk. He's like, what the fuck? Why would you hit me?
Sorry, I thought you were someone else.
He will attack Kethra. Ha! With a 3 and a crit of 11.
Damn.
I haven't used my reaction yet, I don't think.
Yeah, we'll you have use not now. Used your reaction, yeah.
So 7 damage total.
And this one comes running up. We'll also attack Kethra. So the disguise appears to throw them off momentarily, at least.
Oh, what the hell? Does Uncanny Dodge still apply?
Pretty damn good. I believe Uncanny Dodge does last for... Well, it says reaction, doesn't it?
Fine. Minus 11.
I think you only get that reaction once. Kalinar, would you like to attack more plates?
Yes. As I'm running around towards the enemy, I'm smashing plates as I go.
Smash those plates.
Run up here. I'll swing at this dude.
With advantage.
With advantage. We're at 12.
12, you managed to split his head off.
Awesome! So that was 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. He hops.
Music in this combat's gonna be over soon.
Hops up on the table and swings down at this one.
Up onto the shelves.
20.
Oh boy. 14 is massive damage. She fails to resist. And 8 is something. Yep, can't take reactions. Thank you.
And the cleave attack. 14 did not hit.
Not when he uses his parry.
Parried.
We'll use his parry for that. Stalus. This monk's having a bad day. He was just making fajitas, and now his world is shattered.
See if he can parry a firebolt.
Parry this, motherfucker.
No, he cannot. He takes that fire. Still alive, but the air smells like burned flesh. And he does not look good at all. His blood and his skin is welting and popping and sizzling. Now he looks like the fajitas that he once tried to make.
Delicious fajitas.
That's bad touch. Mary,
Here you go, call out. Come, brother. I shall save you.
I wonder how long this ruse is going to work. She's acting like a murderer.
It's all right, brother. I'll get us out of here.
Oh my god! You can have a point of inspiration for that combination of trying to say everything is okay and then brutally murdering him in the most vicious, horrifying way possible. She's like, it's okay, it's okay. You just bring your, like, mace down on his face and just crushes his skull inward. His last thought is like, yay, a friend! And then just shards of skull in his brain. And that appears to be all the monks in the kitchen. Hot coals smolder in two big brick hearths in the middle of this room, and the smell of, it says baking bread, but I'm gonna go with fajitas, fills the air. Sacks of flour, casks of salted fish, crates of dried vegetables, and wheels of cheese clutter the walls, along with well-worn work tables and a collection of mismatched cutlery. And you see a door to the north. It looks like a heavy-duty door. It appears to be probably leading outside, and then a door to the west.
How about this other door?
That is the heavy-duty door that appears to lead outside. You can see from the windows, and again, I'm sorry I didn't do it like this with the dynamic lighting, but these windows point to outside.
Okay.
I was very lazy when I made this map. I did it on the gargoyle ones. For some reason, I didn't do it on the outside ones. Oh, yeah, you can open it.
Huh?
Inside is an umber hulk. No, it's a washroom. The opposite of an umber hulk, in fact. Appears to be a washroom where three large wooden tubs stand.
All right, nothing in here.
This is unexciting. Can I burn these wash tubs?
You can hit them. Solved by burning. There's not enough plates in here to smash. So destructive.
I'd like to eat some cheese.
Rule for eating.
Rule for taking a big chunk out of a cheese wheel.
Yeah, you could probably gather enough food to fill up, we'll say, 3 rations each.
Okay. Not that we've been using rations a whole lot.
Between delicious salted fish and...
fajitas.
And bread. Yeah, and fajitas to go.
Fajitas. Jerky.
That's right. Steak fajitas. Oh,
there's more doors back this way.
Yeah, there's another door over here.
Where does this door go?
That door is unlocked.
Okay.
Are you still wearing the getup?
Yeah, I rotated it around so that way there wasn't blood on the front anymore.
Gotcha. It appears to be a small hallway with a door that leads east.
Okay.
Tell us, materialize.
Gather your party before venturing forth.
I shall open this door.
Alright. Welcome back to the shrine room.
Oh, we made it back around.
There we go. Oh, the dudes. Oh, boy. Okay.
I will gently close the door. We made it back around.
Alright. Nobody seems to actually notice this door open and close, so. You guys can decide how you want to do this.
There's a couple guys in there.
How many is a couple?
I saw at least 2.
Okay. Including the guy who betrayed us, I assume.
I'm assuming.
I want his head. Okay.
Heather says, I saw 3.
Okay.
Y'all want to hang here and I'll go out and call for reinforcements?
Sure. Should we set her up in the kitchen, maybe? Like, right in here?
Yeah.
Try that old trick again.
Good choke point.
Yeah. Go in the kitchen right here.
Roll better for...
You two hide on the other side of the door, and I'll just have a come hither look.
Come at me, boys.
Sexy goblin.
Look like Jonathan.
or yell, they killed Jonathan. Don't know what that means.
what that means.
Alright. I shall open the door again. And walk out.
Did I give you guys the shrine description? Four large columns of natural rock dominate this shrine. A wide set of steps descends into darkness in the center of the room, in front of a slab-like stone altar. Large copper-sheathed doors stand in the middle of the south wall. Smaller doors exit to the east and west. Two narrow windows in the north wall admit thin fingers of light from outside. Above the altar, a triangular symbol has been chiseled into the heavy stone blocks of the wall.
In my most manic voice that I can possibly muster, come quick! The adventurers have escaped! They're in the kitchen! And I'll run back inside.
The priest appears to look up irritated and kind of slams a fist down on the table.
Are they coming?
He walks around the altar. Says, how did they make it over there? Ah! Knew they'd slay the Umberhulk. We've been searching the mines for hours. They've made it up here.
They ate my fajitas.
Yeah. Where's Franklin with my goddamn steak fajitas? Son of a bitch. You hear, he's like, alright, let's go. Kill them once and for all. I need to be rid of this pests.
Gonna do like a fake scream like they killed me. Trying to make them rush. I was like rest against the wall next to the counter like I'm dead.
Yeah.
Turn the rope around. Blood.
Alright, so at this point, when they come around, well, I'll put him here. When he comes around the corner, obviously he can see Talos from here, so we'll go ahead and start the initiative.
I guess I should have hit them.
You guys notice these guys are the appear to be much different than monks. They are wearing this crazy stone golem type armor.
I did not roll a 20 this time. Close.
Oh no!
Well, Kalinar. New things. Alright, where are you, dude? So it should come up with his name if I did it correctly. Okay, good. It says Carbo. Can you guys see his name, or does it show up as Black Earth Priest?
Carbo!
Cool. Alright, I think I figured out how to do that. And he rolled shit for initiative. He was not on top of this. Wow, you guys did terrible all around, didn't you? Except for Mary. Mary, even though you were the one that concocted the whole plan and had to run back, you actually got the jump on everybody.
I'm just resting against the wall and have Light bring her back behind me. Just waiting. There's a bathroom to run this way. So I shall wait until a person is here.
Okay.
They're within super melee range.
Super melee range! Alright, the guards will surge forth. 5, 10, 15. 20 to run up to smash. Hello. Talos. Doesn't notice everybody else till he always runs through the door.
We were laying in wait, but are we just doing like initiative and rolls?
Unfortunately, the way D&D combat system works, we do have to still follow.
Alright.
You know what? No, we'll do a. Hang on, back up.
Because we. Yeah, me and Kether.
We will do. He's still going to make it through. What we're going to do is have you guys roll stealth checks, and that will determine if he comes in and you guys get a chance to
do our lay and wait attacks.
All right. I'm going to hit him regardless.
And essentially what you would be doing
I don't.
Is doing the wait action, because if you did get the stealth round off, you'd be going first, then you would just be you doing an overwatch, and then he would come in
right,
and
do your attack. Right, right.
So. You have to beat his passive perception, which Kalinar does not. Catherine
nope.
does. And are you the guys that are going to be stealth attacking?
I'm hitting him because I did the wait action on my turn.
Yeah, I'm not stealthing.
Okay, so technically, stealth round right now is just Kethra. And we're going to assume that Kethra did the wait action to attack him whenever he hit this square. So essentially what's going to happen is he's going to hit this square, and both Kethra and Miri are going to hit him.
Can I hit him on the square between Kalinar and me?
Yes.
So that we're I'm flanking him?
Yeah. Alright, you'd have advantage anyway. It's a stealth sneak attack.
Oh, okay. Well, fine.
And yeah, we can use your attack.
Oh. I used up all my good rolls.
Oh, no.
Unfortunately, a 13 is not going to hit. Miri's will hit, however. 22 will do 10 damage. So, all that work, he takes 10 damage before he reaches Talus and appears to get ready to pummel you with his Morning Star.
Uh-oh.
Would you like to use divination before he strikes? I guess you've got a shield spell you can use too.
I do.
Alright. Morning Star is against Talus. He does attack twice, BT dubs.
Holy shit.
And crits one of them.
Guess which one I can't block. I'll cast that. Nope. That's the wrong one.
There you go, shield.
So I'll block the first one, then I'll take 17 damage.
Oh boy.
That's exactly half my health.
Swipes you right around the giant spiked club. 5, 10, 15. The other one will come in and stop short when he notices surrounding him. He's going to go after Kethra, since Kethra... out of the two of you that tried to stew the ambush, Kethra attacked.
Man,
these guys are no fun.
Uncanny dodge is a useful ability. And it's
hello.
It's 5 damage. Your turn,
yep.
Kethra.
I'm going to try this again and poke at the guy between Kalinar and myself.
Pokey pokey.
Oh my god.
Jesus, dude!
Damn, dude, you're killing him. You're a big source of damage in this party, too. That would not even hit
a monk.
Let's see, what's something pitiful? Yeah, a monk.
Come
monks
off.
Are pretty decent AC.
Yeah.
Oh, wolf.
And then. I'm gonna disengage.
He skips along the countertops, rattling plates, clacking them onto the ground. Talus.
As a bonus action, I'll cast.
Get the hell out of dodge.
Cast, get the hell out of dodge.
Dispel, yeah.
And then next I'll cast Charm Person at level 2. So I'll attempt to charm both of them.
Ooh.
Charming. Also let's use target more than one.
Yeah.
Alright. Wisdom saves. I guess you'll find out. Wisdom is nothing. Alright, we'll do top guy and then bottom guy. Top guy fails miserably. And bottom guy fails miserably.
Wow!
Or wait. It does with advantage if I or my companions are fighting it. He has advantage on both of those rolls.
How's that?
It says, you must make a wisdom saving throw and does so with advantage if I or my companions are fighting it. You guys are both locked in combat with those guys.
Oh, okay, I see. Damn. That sucks, because the other roll was great.
I would have, yeah, I would have thought that I would have gotten at least one.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Yeah. I rolled really bad and really good.
You missed your step all the way over there.
The advantage works.
So I missed your step, then I walked.
Oh.
I wonder if you could have ambushed him with a charm person, because then you probably could have done it without.
Yeah. That's a good idea.
Next is the priest, who will try and get line of sight of you guys. Alright, he can see Miri. I don't think he can see anybody else.
Still disguised.
You are, but you're right there. He does know that they're fighting dudes in that corner, regardless. Fortunately, all his shit is AoE, so this really helps him. You know what he's gonna do is cast... Spider Climb! He's gonna use his movement to creepily run up the wall! So he can now move freely into this room. 5, 10, 15, 20. Whoops, shit, wrong guy. Too many icons. 15, 20, 25, 30. Move that guy back.
Oh,
so
damn.
He is here, but he is on the ceiling, essentially. And that is his action, so Kalinar.
Oh, boy. The guy's on the ceiling still. Right?
It is, yes. It is a concentration spell, so it lasts as long as he's concentrating.
Kalinar is going to cast Vow of Enmity on the golem man nearest him.
Alright.
He's going to start taking swings at him. 19
will hit. 10 damage. Splinter into his rock armor.
28! I didn't need it.
Oh boy!
Nice!
Crit.
I can reroll that initial damage too.
Okay.
So, let's see. 1d10 plus 5. Eight plus 12 is 20 damage.
20 damage. Alright.
And I get cleave, by the way, because cleave happens on a crit.
Oh, it does. Interesting.
Yes.
Wow.
Okay. You crush into his armor. He's actually still alive, and he appears near death after that gigantic blow.
Oh.
What did you do, 20 damage?
Yeah.
20 is massive damage.
Oh, the 17 didn't hit?
Huh?
I applied that damage also. But the 10 wasn't massive damage, the 20 is.
No, okay, yeah.
You might get lucky.
He resists the trauma, actually. For once. So your cleave does go off.
Okay, yeah. Cleave attack!
I didn't know it did that.
Yes. 16?
16 does not hit.
Okay.
He has super fortified rock armor.
Yep.
Still near death, though.
I'm going to take the rest of my turn to drink a greater potion of health. I don't know if I'll need it right now, but I feel like it's a good idea. 44 plus 4. Nice. I will take 15.
Yep, you're solid.
Alright, that's it for me.
Back to Mary.
Yeah. Let's see here. like Carbo. Q-bar. Barbo.
Carbo. Yeah, as he was spider climbing into the room, he says, "You all have been terrible pain in my side. I don't know how you made it up here. I don't know how you made it around this entire facility. But your path of destruction ends here."
Alright, I'm gonna cast.
He points to a broken plate. That was my favorite plate!
That's what I was gonna get my fajitas on! Alright.
You ruined my dinner! That's the worst offense!
And then I'm gonna use another.
Wait, who are we whipping?
I'm Carbo.
Carbo!
Hold up the ceiling! Do some damage to him!
I'm gonna do another 2 key points worth of damage.
Oh boy.
Yeah, so that's another 2d8, I think. No, what? 2d10. So hang on for the damage.
10 per key, probably.
Yeah, I'm using 2 additional key points.
You mean to roll the dex first, or?
No, because it still counts for the if you fail it.
Oh, that's true. Just half damage.
So 2d10. So another 13. So 29 damage.
Boy,
nice.
Alright.
Ha! He does not.
He fails.
Nice.
29 damage. Holy balls.
Presumably you're pulling him off the ceiling too, right?
Yeah.
He will use his unyielding ability to not move, however.
He doesn't have a choice. Because it creates a whip of water to shove or pull a foe to unbalance it, knock it prone, or pull it 25 feet closer.
Says he can use his reaction to avoid being either moved or knocked prone from any effect.
Oh, wow. Okay, so you can just counter
one
that.
One with the earth, even on the ceiling.
Even on the ceiling!
One with... roll concentration.
He does need to roll concentration, that's true.
Yeah.
There's a thing for him. Why did that not work? Oh, we need to enter out of it. There we go.
That's his reaction, too.
That is his reaction. Okay, so what was concentration? That was half... half the damage, or 10 plus... or just 10?
Yeah, I can't...
I really need to remember this, I know.
Yeah, I think it's 10 or half the damage taken, whichever one's greater.
Which this one would be greater, so that's... 14?
Mm-hmm.
So he has to roll a con save, make a 14 or higher. Oh! Double fail! So while the whip can't move him, you mess up the concentration of his spell, which causes his spider climb to no longer work, which causes him to fall 10 feet to the ground.
Just the pavement, dude.
Would you like to roll the damage, or should I? It's 1d6 per 10 feet, so 2d6.
I'll roll it.
And he
just
taking,
for fun.
He will have to roll for massive damage as well.
So another 8 damage.
Holy crappers.
I think that spider clam might have been a bad idea. just run into the room.
Yep, he was overzealous about that. Uh-oh, failed that. Let's see what the massive damage does. A 5, which I think means he's stunned.
He is.
Good lord!
Wow.
He is stunned until the
he
end of his next turn.
Holy,
that was an insane move. You just unleashed, like, everything on him.
Yep.
He also appears near death from the insane amount of damage and fall he just took.
He's just laying on the ground, just bleeding out of his nose.
Yes, yes. Doesn't even say a word. He's just, like, more, well, literally stunned. However, the guards are next.
Oh, and then I'll take my last key point for patient defense. PT though.
Wow, yeah. That's pretty nice that you get all your key points after a short rest.
Yeah, and I just use every last one.
She was on the nitrous hard.
That was a pretty good fucking use of them.
Oh, man.
Alright, the guards are somewhat shaken. By that, and they will each try to attack their combatants. We'll do Kalinar first. The swing their morning stars. Oh!
All sorts of balls. I'm glad I drank that potion now.
Oh shit.
What is that, 26?
How many crits have we had this game? My god, between all of us.
It feels like a lot. I think it's 26, right?
15 and 11 is 26 damage.
Yeah.
Miri, would you like 26 damage? Let's see what I can do.
No, I've got my patient defense on.
I hope it doesn't happen again, because I can't take another hit like that.
15 and 7. Wow. You avoided a crit with patient defense. That's really
good. Wow.
You avoided a lot of damage with that this session.
Yes, I have. Now that I know how to use it.
The real MVP is patiently defending.
He may or may not have spent 40 minutes trying to explain how to use it correctly, but I figured it out.
I don't ever make you guys take massive damage, do I?
Mm-mm.
Yeah, that's right, only NPCs.
You said early on that your replacement for that was the going down the last
lingering
wound
injury,
thing.
Yeah, that's right.
Which I don't think has ever happened.
Yeah. I think Catherine went down once against the Flame Skull. But you guys have come really close. The challenge level has seemed pretty damn good so far.
Yeah.
A lot of you guys have been knocking at death's door, but rarely actually go down. Kethra is scooting back along the kitchen counters.
Uh-huh. Going for this guy between Kalanar and myself. Let's see if I can do better.
That's better.
That is better, and that will kill him. Nice. You slide that rapier up into his face mask, I don't know.
And then I'm going to move here.
Goes to the ground, and the armor starts to crumble inward, crushing him. You're just, like, jumping over onto the benches.
Jumping over furniture.
Yep. Talos.
I'll cast Magic Missile at the guard.
Magic Missile him!
That is a good thing to do against high AC guys, isn't it? Seven.
Yeah.
Nine damage.
Even against low AC guys, to be honest.
That's
guaranteed
true,
damage.
Yeah, that is pretty nice, guaranteed. Alright, 9 damage they fling into him. He appears to be wounded. Straight wounded. Carbo is stunned, and now that it's the end of his turn, he's not stunned, but he loses his turn from being rushed to death by his own weight and whipping. Kalanar.
Kalanar is going to step around this guy. Bryce doesn't even have to, does he? Cause
nope.
Kethra's right there.
You've got all kinds of flanking opportunities.
Yep. Alright, I'm just going to start swinging.
24 will hit. 10 damage. He appears very badly wounded.
Another 20.
25.
I have to roll it. Reroll that one.
Okay. Really? Oh, yeah, 2.
2, yeah.
Wow.
10 plus 5. Ha! Look at that!
That is a killing blow.
Nice! Well, in that case, I'm going to step over to this Carbo getting off the ground.
Yeah.
He doesn't have much life left.
He does not
have much life left, no. I'm trying to coup de
grace. He is prone, so I believe you have advantage on this attack roll as well.
Oh,
that's good.
Yeah, that's good.
That is good. 26 will hit.
Also rerolling my damage.
Okay.
For a little bit, one more point.
8 damage. He appears near death now. As you bring your sword down into him, he just kind of shudders a bit. And coughs up blood. Mary, how appropriate. We are back to you. Is on the ground, sputtering blood.
Mary will look at Carbo and just whisper, "Shh, it's okay."
Oh, God. So wrong.
It's like sociopath behavior there.
22 will hit, and a 6 will end the career of Carbo, the fajita-loving Black Earth priest.
As
you silently, it's like the, shit, what am I doing? Stop. Why is...
Uh-oh.
Sorry.
It's like game over music.
My thing freaked out, so I started clicking the play button on the music instead of the stop button. Oh god, all the music is starting.
Dun.
Loss of the fajitas.
Yes. Yeah, I imagine that scene from Saving Private Ryan, where you're just, like, whispering, shh, 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 and, like, slowly shoving the dagger into his body.
Yeah.
Nasty. All right. That is the end of that encounter.
Thank God I didn't take any damage. But I have no people.
Kalinar took some bad ones from that one hit.
Took half my life from one hit. That's how they seem to work.
Have anything on his body?
Carbo appears to have a ring on him. That appears to be magical.
Magic rings.
I think you have to identify it first through the resting ritual.
I'm really good at resting.
I don't know how to do that.
Otherwise, he doesn't appear anything on it, anything on him, and you feel like you probably already looted his room.
One mysterious ring.
These guards, I assume that it's the same deal with the other ones.
So same thing as the monks, they don't appear to carry any worldly possessions on them.
They're just rock monsters.
Rock monsters! In here, you recognize the shrine that you first met Carbo and went sailing down the stairs. Like a day and a half ago at this point.
Yep.
What is on the altar?
You can do a
visual inspection with my eyeball?
A religion check.
Oh, this isn't going to go well.
And you can do a religion check.
Ha! Nope.
Kethra, you're still figuring out what a religion is.
Mm-hmm.
Mary, you are confused. Talus is the only one that recognizes the marks. Shows that this temple was once dedicated to Moradin, which I hope is a dwarven god. I do not know D&D very well. So obviously the Earth cult did not build this temple. It is very old and appears to have been once been dwarven. It was a temple to a dwarven god. But there are like crude carvings of the Earth cult symbol like around the area. Not crude, we'll call them nice carvings.
Alright.
There's another door.
I think it leads back to a hallway that we were in before, but you go ahead and open it and see.
Still got my mask on with my bloody sheets.
That door is locked.
Damn it.
Oh.
Gather on!
I just try to walk up to the doors and just unlocking it, so.
Show off. Jesus!
Wow.
That mage hand is a bit of a flourish as it's doing it.
Oh, no. This is something else entirely.
It goes outside, there's gargoyles.
Oh, I remember them talking about this little area.
A walled garden shelters beneath the northern wall of the monastery. The garden is poorly kept, although some effort has been made to clear footpaths through the overgrowth. A garden gate to the northeast appears to lead outside. And there are three doors that connect this area. The one you just went through, one in the south, and one in the east. And obviously there are gargoyle statues everywhere, which particularly gruesome and intimidating.
I'd like to cast Divine Sense.
Celestial Fiend or Undead. You notice nothing out of the ordinary.
Alright. Still don't. Yeah.
Possibly. As you guys walk through the path, however, two of the gargoyle statues will spring to life.
Of course. Of course.
Hey, get back there, Mary. As gargoyle statues oft do.
Just two of them, though?
Just two of them. The two nearest to the west side. So the northwest guy and the one that's...
But it's not nighttime.
They can't do that. I know the rules.
Somebody's watched too much of the cartoon.
Damn it! I am just rolling shit for initiative. This entire session.
Unfortunately, the statues will remain there, so suspend your disbelief.
Statues are also much larger than the characters.
Yeah, I just had to find like a roll, because unfortunately the base map just came with little circles as the
symbol. Really?
Like, that's dumb, so I found some cool statues. But yeah, gargoyles are actually medium, which...
Okay.
Just kind of man-sized. And... Not that much better, although you guys also did kind of shit, except for Mary. Alright, Mary has got the chump. So only the, like I said, these two gargoyles actually sprang to life.
Okay. 5, 10 Since I still have my wonderful disguise on. Protect me from the intruders! Look that way.
I wonder if the gargoyles care whether or not we're...
Probably not.
Let's find out. Kethra.
That was your action? Oh, jeez.
You can still ready in action if you want. Mary. Because speaking doesn't really count as an action.
Yeah.
You just, like, if they attack you, then...
Yeah, if they attack me, then I'll fight back.
Attack back, okay.
Yeah.
Kethra...
Alright, I will also ready my crossbow, and if it attacks somebody, I will shoot.
Overwatch, everyone! Alright, first gargoyle will essentially leap off its pedestal and do a attacking motion, appears to acknowledge Miri's wardrobe, turns around, and leaps at Kalinar.
Oh no!
So, your crossbow will go off at this point.
Which one? The one close to us or the top left one?
They both will be attacking, so you can actually choose whichever one you want to attack. But this one will obviously be attacking first because he's closer. So probably
yeah,
makes sense for you to shoot that
I was
one.
Aiming at that one. So, okay. Oh.
14 is not going to hit a gargoyle.
Oh. That's good.
So, we'll see. Attacks. Kalinar makes a bite and claw attack.
Damn. Alright, well, the bite works.
Which are literally the same thing stat-wise, but hey. it's cool to picture him biting and clawing at you. So. A crit and then a terrible roll.
Yep.
How many crits have we gotten? Holy balls.
A lot.
But
I've eaten a good number of them.
Alright, and the second one will fly... From his pedestal, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, attack Kethra. You guys are still very wounded, too.
We are. It's not the best shape.
Shoot. Terrible.
Don't even have to ask.
Roll terrible. Alright, Kalinar.
Kalinar will drink a potion of health. 44 plus 4.
Do another greater one?
This is, wow, that was great. I'll take
that. That was really good. Max, you could have rolled his 20.
Yeah. Alright, and he'll start swinging at the one near him. Hey, that was my last health potion. 26.
Talon is a magical sword, right?
Yes.
Alright. 7 damage.
I have to reroll the damage, actually. I was wondering.
Okay.
13 damage!
13's a little better. He appears somewhat wounded. As you chunk into his. These guys are basically made of stone, by the way.
Oh, I wonder if my. Alright, well, it's too late now, but... Nice!
Oh boy.
So I had to reroll that first one, too.
Jeez, what is up with these crits today? Holy crap! It's crazy!
So it's 8 plus 15.
23 damage. That's like a Kethra number right there.
Yeah.
23 is not quite massive damage. But he appears badly wounded now after that crushing slice attack.
And cleave. Right. Cause like crit.
Yeah, cleave because you crit. Yeah, damn. Holy balls.
10's probably not going to do it, though.
10 is not going to hit. Finally,
he used all his energy.
Holy balls. Talus. So the one gargoyle is badly wounded. This one is fresh from the perch.
All right. I'll cast Firebolt at the one that's badly wounded.
All right. He'll bounce off his stone form.
Okay, wait. I'll use Inspiration.
No, okay. Yeah, you do have inspiration.
Inspiration will,
so inspired.
Attack him. And he is, several chunks of him burns off. And he appears like misshapen, but, still alive, but appears very near death. After that assault, back up to Miri.
Please join the fight. Kill them for me!
I'm thinking about the fact that they listened or they paid attention to the clothing that I'm wearing. And I'm wondering if I could end the fight without having to kill the gargoyles.
Oh. Yeah, I mean, talking doesn't cost much. You could try.
Mm-hmm. It's one of those, I wonder if I can tell them to, like, not attack or something. To go back to their post.
Give a shot.
Alright. So I guess I will call out in my best stone monk voice for the gargoyles to return to their post.
They appear to be mostly ignoring it, appear to be just locked into combat at this point.
Alright. Well, assholes.
And fuck them!
5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Anyway, because you have almost killed that one. Twenty-seven
is a crit, wow. And will hit.
27 again!
What is going on with the crits, people? What in the hell?
17.
Alright, slow down. Hang on. How much damage is this?
First one's 14. Then 9.
33. Total.
Are your monk hands magical by now? Or not?
The hands are. The Lightbringer is. I don't know.
Lightbringer
about
is, but is your Unarmed Strike magical?
I don't know. Where's the book?
It happens at some point.
You're the one who tells me these things. How am I supposed to know?
Have you seen how much I keep track of? It's too many things. What is the other damage? The two Lightbringers?
Yeah, the two Lightbringers are 23.
23. My goodness. That is going to be massive damage on this one.
Do you add them, though?
Oh, you're right. That wasn't technically one blow. That was two.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's true.
Two blows. 23. I don't know where to look for this.
Just the monk section and maybe on level up somewhere.
I'm looking.
We can go to Kethra. He's either going to take 6 damage or 3 damage, essentially.
Oh, man. Is there any magic? Does a dagger that lights up count as magic?
Yes, I think it is magic. Yeah.
It is magic.
So will I have observed this?
Yes. Once she hits with her fists. Well, I guess it depends if it's magic or unmagic, but since you now know anyway, it's not going to matter.
Well, I mean, my sword was magic, and her lightbringer was magic, so both of those have been doing...
But right, but you wouldn't notice unless it was, like, magic. Not magic, and then that blow, appeared to not do as much damage.
Yeah.
But cat's out of the bag now, so...
I don't think it is.
I know at some point you specifically level up and gain that perk that your fists do count as magical.
That's a six.
Six, okay.
Yeah,
so they're not...
starting at sixth level, your unarmed strikes count as magical.
Alright, so he takes three damage, and Catherine, you notice that her non-magical fists don't do as
react
much damage, just kind of graze off of it.
So Catherine, seeing this, pulls out her Red Zer dagger. And,
see, now you're glad I gave you a bullshit magical weapon, aren't you?
For special effect, she whispers, Red Zer. And the dagger lights up. Glows. Like a lightsaber.
A little mini blue lightsaber,
And she tries to poke him with it.
Stabby,
pokey poke.
17 will hit.
Oh, wow.
For 18.
Yeah. So it was not magic, it was half?
Correct.
Wow.
Nice. God damn it, Raymond. You're
both
like,
gargoyles
you
are
pull
extremely...
your bullshit dagger out of your belt and do 18 damage.
Yes, you did. Whereas he did like everything awesome to do 20. So
yeah.
Both gargoyles are extremely near death, but unfortunately it is now their turn.
I know.
And their attacks are not weakened by being extremely near death. So one of them will attack Kalinar.
Wow.
Look
at
damage.
Look at your
just look at that damage.
That was a one hits.
So only one the claws get through for 3 damage. Other gargoyle has been will attack Kethra from he doesn't like that light up little toy you've got.
Hey.
Damn.
21 and 15. Is that 8 hit? I don't think you've used your reaction either.
Yeah, I'll go uncanny dodge. So it's 13 divided by 2, so 6 damage.
Oh, does 15 hit you too?
I have 15, so it ties. So yes.
Okay, gotcha.
So I say 6 damage?
Yes. You might have the lowest AC of the group, assuming, because Talos always has either Mage Armor or Shield up. Kalinar.
Try to finish this one off.
You guys did a bunch of damage, and just literally there are like 1 or 2 hit points or whatever.
Yep. There you go.
The hell is going on? I am gonna get. You know what? I'm gonna send these buttons back to the shop. We're gonna get new ones. If this was a tabletop game, I'd be throwing all of your dice away at this point. No.
Wait a dice. You go on the track.
You don't get all these crits. That is insane. Yeah, that one is crushed beyond reason. As it just disintegrates and falls apart.
Yeah, I'll step up to the other one.
Roll the crit again.
Nope, but I didn't roll full damage.
Insane amounts of damage. Alright, you killed both of them quite swiftly. Jeez. Insane offering. The other gargoyle statues appear to actually be statues. Or perhaps gargoyles just aren't functioning correctly, but for whatever reason, they are not activating. Only those two, and they are destroyed. They have nothing on
them. If I were a gargoyle, I would not activate after seeing that slot.
Can I take my great maul out and go around smashing gargoyle statues?
Alright, yeah, you go around smashing them up. The place is a giant rubble, and the gargoyles do not respond. They appear to actually be statues.
Good.
And the whole place is now just a ruin.
Okay. Which door?
How about this one?
Yes, let's go south.
I'm gonna drink a potion. What was that, 2d plus 4? I mean, 2d4 plus 4?
Is it a healing or greater healing?
It's regular.
Regular is 2d4 plus
2? What is 2d4 plus 4?
I don't know. I haven't used one in a long time.
Yeah,
plus 2.
Yeah, the greater one is 44 plus 4.
Huzzah.
That's pretty good. with that healing potion. This is back where we were.
Yeah, the stairs lead back up to the hallway filled with dead monk corpses. You guys made a giant circle.
Yep, we did. Of death. All right. Well,
stay down here.
Yeah. Well, there's the room. There's the room to the east over here that we have not opened. In that case, or there's two doors over here, isn't there?
Which door? Oh, this door up here appears to lead outside of the monastery.
Okay.
And then you've got this door right here.
If my memory serves, this is the only door we have not opened. The only room we've not gone in. And
there's two more back in that original hallway that we didn't go into.
Okay.
Before we went into the kitchen and you started breaking things.
This door appears like it has not been opened in some time. It appears like closed shut. And
does this lead to the Lich's room?
That is an excellent hypothesis. appears to have dangerous arcane words written on it in warning.
Oh.
Yeah, that looks
good. To read them.
Yeah, it appears to be... It says, stay the fuck back, bitches.
Bart Dorgan. Now, we did say we would let Larry from State Farm go.
We did, yes. Should we head back towards him and let him loose? I believe we've cleared out as much of this place as we know to clear out.
Yeah.
There's a lot of bad things in this place.
Wait, are we not waiting to see if Talos can read that door?
We said he did. He just said stay out.
Yeah, it's basically...
In colorful language.
Yes.
In that case...
Talos, you recognize the exact same patterns as the one in the crypt.
Okay.
It basically was warding people away and appears to have been done by the Lich.
With the fog cloud? I mean, with the cloud?
Yeah.
Yeah, Larry's apparent is still.
Larry's over
bound
here.
Again. He's actually resting when you come across him.
Well, Kether wants to open the door.
Oh no! It's warded.
What door?
Something bad will happen.
Stand far away.
That's the Lich's room, presumably.
He should welcome us then.
Well, he won't. I mean, he sets those. Glyphs. He doesn't actually, control them after he sets them.
This one, when you attempt to open it, just appears magically sealed.
Oh, really?
Like, the door, glows.
Doesn't have a trap on it?
Doesn't have a trap on it, yeah, but it appears, just impenetrable.
You just can't open it. You try.
I refuse to believe it.
Hates heavy places he can't get into.
Shall we talk to Larry and release Larry?
Sure.
Oh, we also have to release all the prisoners down in the dungeon.
Yeah, we do have to go down and tell them that they're free to go.
They've been there for a day and a half.
They're fine. Oh, we could. If we talk this into Larry, we can send Larry.
I don't trust Larry. Larry, we can trust Larry as far as leaving. We ungag Larry.
Why does Larry look like he has a mask on?
That was the gag symbol I had. Alright, you ungag him. He was resting, now he appears kind of groggy.
Does he say anything?
No. He just stares intently. He didn't even stare at any of you, he just kind of looks like sullen.
Do you speak common, son? Does he still have his mask on?
I assume you guys took it off, but.
Yeah, we did. Put the ball gag in.
Yeah, exactly.
Wait, a ball gag?
He nods slowly. Still doesn't look at you.
Do you understand what has happened to this place?
He pauses for a moment and then kind of nods again.
Do you know what was in the room to the northeast of this monastery?
He actually looks at you with some disbelief and... kind of slowly nods and then kind of does an unsure shake of his shoulders. Says, kind of almost whispers, like, they told us not to worry about it, never to go near it.
That room now contains the owner of this building. You are no longer welcome here. Do you understand me?
He says, I hear he already knows the Abbess is dead. He's a, he nods.
Yeah, he punched her in the face.
Yes, he did. He was the one. That's why his demeanor's so, like, shaken.
What have I done?
Yeah.
The being in that room will now be the sole occupant of this monastery. Any attempt to re-enter it will be met with the full wrath of that creature. Do you understand that?
You kill everyone here to put that thing in charge? To rule that, this place?
That is what has happened.
Play nice now, Larry.
He appears like sullen and pouty again. But and seems to nod to your
I just unmanacle him.
Statements.
And oh, in almost a sneer he goes, your services have been greatly appreciated.
He glares at you, but like kind of rubs his wrists and eyes the door.
Leave now and find yourself a better life.
Roll persuasion.
Okay.
To see if he finds himself a better life.
Cal doesn't really care if he finds himself a better life, but sure. 24.
Alright. He kind of studies you seriously for a moment. A little color comes back into his face, and he kind of... His face goes through a range of emotions and contortions, and he finally like nods a little more seriously. And instead of bolting for the door, he just kind of like walks out purposefully.
Larry finds a wife, has 3.5
As he's leaving, Kether says, go find Jonathan's family and be with them in this time of need. Yeah. I'm sure it would mean a lot to him if you were there.
Jonathan says hello.
Larry.
All right. There is the one hallway right outside the shrine with gargoyles in it.
Calnar, you can earn a point of inspiration for...
Oh. For convincing him to live a good life?
Yeah, giving Larry clemency.
Wait, there's a hallway over here that'll lead downstairs.
That's true. Yeah, we should go let those people go. That's
right.
It's
this door?
That door might be...
Oh, look at Gargoyle Hall.
The hallway you go downstairs.
That's up north of you.
Oh, okay. This door, then. Ah, there it is.
Yeah, that one leads downstairs. If you guys just want to tell me, I don't have to drag you guys back down to the basement.
Yeah, we'll just go down there and find the group.
Yeah, you notice when you go down there, about half of them are missing.
Oh, no.
It has been a day and a half.
They left.
Broldenthar is still down there, and he says, yeah, it was all kinds of, like, survivor shit down here. Like, people were, like, deciding on what to do. Some of them wanted to come up and help you. Some of them just wanted to flee. Finally, about half of them just took off. The ones that worked in the mines worked out a shaft in the southwestern part that led directly to the outside. So those guys just left on their own, and I wanted to stay here and wait for you guys and convinced another of other ones that were too sickly and weakened to make it out on their own.
All right. Well, Kalinar offers to escort them, Broomhild or whatever his name is, how do you pronounce it?
Roldenthar.
escort him and the remaining prisoners back to town.
Back to town? Which town are you going to?
I don't know. Where are we going?
To the desert. So are you guys leaving the monastery?
Presumably. Well, if we're doing that, before we leave, though...
There were two doors left.
Were they really?
I mean, back to town is a big journey at this point. It's...
Red Larch?
Not a big journey, but... Yeah, Red Larch is what, 5, 10, 15, 20? You can do that in a day.
Yeah. Give us a good place to long rest and just head out again.
That's true.
Yeah, are we ready to leave?
Do we want to explore those two doors?
That's up to you guys.
Which two doors?
The one before the kitchen.
Sure.
At this point, you guys have... Wait, which doors?
There were two doors before the kitchen, I think.
2 days before the kitchen.
Two doors before the kitchen.
Wait, this one? I don't know.
No, this one. What's funny?
The kitchen led outside. Is that what you're thinking?
No.
Where Kether is right now.
Oh, okay. You want to open that door?
Once everybody else gets here.
Take us there. I don't know where you went.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, right. This is the hallway. This is the gargoyle hallway.
Yeah.
Which, we might fight some gargoyles in here.
Oh, yeah, that's not going there, man.
Like that's all it's going
to
be in
the
here.
Hallway, you notice the hallway that you guys were taken through to go to the shrine initially, and it is lined with gargoyle statues.
Yeah.
You guys never actually went in this hallway after...
Nope. I'm good with not going in there.
Not fighting.
Yeah, you guys literally went in a giant circle around this monastery, so you technically never went in this hallway without being escorted.
So. Alright, yeah, let's just leave.
Alright.
Before we leave, though, Kalinar does go back to Renwick and tells him that he's thought long and hard about the things that they've discussed, and Kalinar swears his sword to Renwick's service as his lord.
Nice. He graciously accepts and does it with all the regal honor befitting his like station. He basically still acts and considers himself a member of the order, like a high-ranking member of the Knights of Samalar.
Right.
Even though he doesn't actually like affiliate with them at all at this point.
Yes, Kalinar is now. He's like now. I believe we with the. Time and the wisdom afforded your undeath, you can see things that the Order now cannot. Your service at here is surely far greater than theirs. Only you can make our Order great again.
Kalinar prints out bumper stickers that say Redwood Kalinar, like 785, whatever this fucking year it is.
Makes the Samalar great again.
Yeah, he gets t-shirts made. With the lich's face on them. make Faerun great again. Vote undead.
The lich fake spray tan.
Yeah.
A spray tan. He's got a thumbs up. Hollow eyes looking out. He appears very jonesed about this encounter and expresses his deep gratitude for you guys clearing out the mines. He says he's going to use his magic to help dispose of all the bodies and any kind of traps or structures that are here.
Oh, right, yeah. That's the other thing I told him. When I went back to Miles, I told him the whole monastery is his now. Like, he can move out as much as he wants.
He does mention, as you guys are leaving, that there is a staircase that goes lower below the mines. And he mentions that the one thing that he might have to change in making this a shrine is to board up that entire basement area, because he says that staircase goes very, very deep, and even he hasn't explored down there, but he says it once connected to essentially a small dwarven like citadel. Underground.
Oh, that's the...
Called Tyre Basil.
That could have been cool.
I remember seeing a thing about that. One of the notes we picked up or something, right?
Yeah.
I can't remember.
Well, he hasn't boarded it up yet.
I mean, he's not going to be able to get to work like right away. He says
that
avenue is still open.
Okay.
He basically says that he will make it so you guys can come back anytime and get down there if you so wish. He will keep this area free.
Okay.
He'll use his magic to keep out any bad dudes. With that, you guys complete the Sacred Stone Monastery, essentially, and you can travel west to Red Larch with a group. It does slow you down, but you will make it there relatively unmolested, especially since you destroyed the spire, and that is cleared out. And you guys can kind of avoid the Sighing Valley as well, so you don't. There's no flying creatures overhead or any more of that. At all. Uh-oh. I was going to say, nobody's reacting. Did I just lose the internet? Oh, no. Crap. Why at the end? Curses. Curses. Yeah. And we lost it. All right. Well, I'm going to go ahead and end this recording then. That will stop our session. I will award XP in a second. But what a terrible ending. I don't have my music either. So thank you to Chris. Hell, you know, it might come back. I don't know.
No, I think it's dead.
Might just be deadsies. Where is it?
Do you have my...
Yeah, I'll remember. Try again. Okay. Yeah, I'll go ahead and end this session. With them returning to town, nothing bad will happen, and I will be rewarding a bunch of XP, and then we will see everybody next week on D&D 5th Edition Princes of the Apocalypse. No music tonight, so sad, stupid, internet breaking. Alright. Bye!